Hello everyone, welcome to our Easy Redmine webinar, and today we are going to talk about tricks and hints for working with tasks in Easy Redmine. My name is Hedviga Cebová, and this presentation was prepared by Eliška Korupcová, our consultant. So today we are going to see how you can make your work with tasks in Easy Redmine faster and easier by using easy buttons, checklists, and magic buttons. So easy buttons are the fastest way of updating your tasks. Just by one click, you can change more attributes in your tasks, or via drag and drop, you can assign a task to a specific person. So those are these colorful buttons which you can add to your right panel next to the list of tasks, or you can find it in the task under the task. When you click at it, you will update the task. Then we have checklist. With checklist, you can eliminate the possibility of forgetting a step. So under your task, you can create unlimited number of items. When you are done with your item, you will just mark it as it is finished. You can also click or create a checklist templates and add these templates to your task. You can have more checklists on one task. And then you can set up your task that every change will be saved in the history of task, and also the progress of task will be changing according to your done items. So in our picture, in our case, our task is done for 50%. And the last one is magic buttons. So you can generate a task with prefilled attributes just by one click. And this will create you actually a task template. And you can bookmark a link in your browser for creating this task, or you can save a magic button to your main menu. So in my picture here, you can see how I use it actually in our Easy Redmine at work. And at one click, I can create a new feature request, I can report a bug, I can contact our support just with a simple task. So during webinar, please use the Q&A section for your questions. And now I'm going to play you a video from Eliška, which she prepared for us to show us all these free features.
Hello and welcome to the webinar on Easy Redmine hints and tricks. My name is Eliška and I'm an Easy Redmine consultant. Today I will show you rather simpler features which can make your work in the system much easier though. I will focus these three groups of features. First of them are easy buttons, which enable you to change fast some tasks' attributes. Checklists, which can be added to your tasks so that you can get a better overview on the partial goals of that task and its fulfillment. And links to task templates, which are related to the need of predefine some attributes of a task which is to be created. I will explain all of these topics more in detail, and I'll start with easy buttons. So to explain what this is about, I will use an easy example of assigning a task to myself quickly. So let's say that this is a project implementations where we can find all the implementations we do for our clients. These are new implementations which are waiting for an assignee. So I will open the task, use this button, and like this, I have assign the task to myself, and at the same time I change the status to realization. Actually, easy buttons are very often used on our help desk plugin, so I will show you its further usage in this plugin. This is my help desk dashboard. Here there is a list of all the tickets, the new tickets submitted by our clients. I got also the description displayed, but it is not necessary. It can be set differently. And when I open a ticket, I can use these buttons to change assignee or to classify the task, for example, as a bug. So here I have changed the tracker to back. You don't even have to go to the task detail, and you can just use drag and drop to assign a task under one of these easy buttons. So this is about how it works, and now how we can configure that. So it is here in others, easy buttons. Let's check just the configuration of one of these. Of course, you can set your own buttons. So this is my ticket button. Here you can set the conditions which a task must meet for the button to be displayed, to be active on that task. So this button is used for tasks which are service tasks, which has no assignee, and which are in the status new. When I push the button, the actions which will be taken are that the assignee will get changed to me, and the status will be changed to realization. So this is for easy buttons. And let's move to the next topic, which are checklists. Let's have a look at how a checklist look in the application. So now I am in a task detail, and I can find my checklist here. It actually works easily. Here are all the items, all the partial goals of this task, and once one of them is fulfilled, I will just check that part, and the track of all the changes is kept here. Actually, if you notice, I have fulfilled just two of these items, and the percentage done is 50%. If I check three of them, we can see that the percentage done increased, because it can be set the way that this progress is linked to the fulfillment of these items. Sometimes the checklist items are getting replaced by subtasks, but sometimes you might find this way more convenient, especially if you want to keep the structure of your project simple and if all these tasks have the same assignee. If you want to set your own checklist, first of all, make sure that the module is active on the project. So we can find the module right here. Then go to task detail and create a new checklist. Where you can add different items. It's actually pretty easy. I will show you also the global checklist configuration. It can be found in administration and checklist templates. You can actually define the templates so that you don't have to create a new checklist for your task, but when you are creating the checklist, you can select it from your templates. And there is some simple checklist settings where you can choose whether you want to count the checklist progress to your percentage done of the task and whether you want to keep the track of the history. Okay, so we are done with the second topic, and now we will speak about the links to task templates to explain what this will be about. I will just show you the standard task template, which we find when creating a new task. So we can see that actually the user is required to fill out some fields, and he is able to see a lot of fields here, which is not required always, especially if we want, for example, our client to submit a help desk ticket. So I'd like to show you what will be the view of a client to when he accesses this application. He doesn't have to be logged in, and he can get this view. This template to create a new task is different from the one I showed you, as the number of the fields here is pretty reduced. He is asked to fill out just the subject and the description of the task. This is actually a module of homepage, which I can find here. If I want to adjust the homepage, I can select from different modules. I have selected new task here, and I can select which fields will be visible for the clients and which will be not. Some fields I just must predefine, as there cannot be any task without a project. I predefine the project, and I select also the tracker, otherwise the default tracker will be selected. So that's it. There are other options how to use a predefined task template. These are rather for our internal employees though. For example, here my development department can use this link to report a bug. If I open this link, I can see that actually some fields are already predefined. Here there is the relevant project, the tracker is selected, even the priority, and here we can find some guidelines for in the description of how to submit the bug correctly. Well, when I want to create a template like this, the first thing I need to do is to get this URL address. So let's try to create a new template. This is the standard new task template. I will define it the way I need. Okay. What I have actually done before, I have saved a bookmark where I inserted a specific code, which will be provided to you after the webinar. And once I predefined my template like this and I push the bookmark, I will get this URL address. Then the last thing to do is to get it here to the top menu. Actually, we can control this top menu through the user type settings. So I go to administration, user types. I'm internal, so I will adjust the custom menu accordingly, and I will insert my address here. Then all you need to do is you need to check which user type is assigned to the user you want to see. You want to see this link. And there is another place where you can post some links to your task templates. It's just your personal homepage where you can insert the module notice board containing some links as well, like this one. So again, I can get to my report back template. It is actually easy to create a notice board like this. We can check its settings. Again, I have posted, I have selected the module here. And then I have just inserted these links here. And to create the button, I have put down button positive in this field. This is a hint for you how this kind of button can be created. So this is it from my side. I hope it was useful for you, and I'll see you the next time.
Great. So we have seen now a presentation from Eliška where we could see or learn how we can work with tasks in EasyRedmine faster. So I just want to emphasize that all these three features are in the core of EasyRedmine. And if you don't find them or if there is any problem, just contact me and we will fix it. And I hope you liked our webinar today. Actually, this is the last webinar of this year, and I'm looking forward to meeting you next year. And I would like to also ask you, if you liked our webinar, I started here a little poll for you. So if you can rate our webinar. And if you still have some questions, don't hesitate to contact me. I will help you with everything. And if you still have some ideas for next webinars, just let me know, and we will be happy to prepare your webinars. Okay, thank you very much for your rating. Thank you very much also for watching, and have a nice day. Bye-bye.